That's the sound reminding you that you have about 1 minute to get to class. If you don't make it there, you could get caught in a tardy sweep. What does that mean? And what will happen if you do?
Ready, set, go!
The new policy here at West High is that for unspecified periods, teachers are instructed to lock their doors as soon as the final bell rings to start class. Anyone who does not arrive in their class on time will get swept. This means that you will need to get a ticket from an administrator before you can enter your class. Also, each time you are swept, it is recorded, and there are consequences. The first time, don't worry, it's just a warning, and your parents are contacted. The second time, you have to serve detention during lunch. So no eating with friends or hanging out on the South Lawn. Instead, you sit in this room for the whole lunch period. The third time, you'll have to serve 2 lunch detentions. The fourth, fifth, and sixth time is after school detention, and it gets longer each time. Additional punishments are as follows. Parent conference with week-long detention, in-school suspension, a referral to district student services for truancy, and so on. Basically, if you're late, there's a punishment. And the more you're late, the worse it gets. So be on time, or you could end up spending hours of your life in here, or worse.
September was Deaf Awareness Month, and we spoke with a supporter, Ms. Paul. Ms. Paul is the American Sign Language teacher here at West High School.
So I'm involved in Deaf Awareness here at West High because I have these amazing sign language classes, and I get to teach my students all about deaf people, about deaf culture, and that they can do anything a hearing person can except for they can't hear, and that's the only thing they can't do. For people to learn more about deaf people, about ASL language, and just appreciate the fact that they have their own culture.
Although many people may think being deaf is a negative, bad thing, and a handicap, it is not. Ms. Paul and her students are very passionate about the fact that being deaf is not a handicap.
It's not really a disability. It's more, deaf people view it as more of something that brings them all together, not really something that hinders them.
Bringing awareness to deaf people and also as well as deaf culture and just not viewing them as disabled and just American Sign Language as like a language.
To help spread deaf awareness, I would just say I always encourage my students to just talk with other friends about deafness, about ASL, and when they see them signing, you know, teaching other people about ASL, about deaf culture. And so that just that little thing of just spreading it amongst the students is a really big thing. Social media also plays a really big role in it, sharing videos. There's a lot of really great and amazing material out there now for people to share.
If you are interested in deaf awareness or sign language, please speak with Ms. Pohl in room 301. This has been Sierra talking with TV West.
Welcome back, West High, to Electives Elevated, where I will help you elevate your knowledge on the many electives here at West High. Today, we will be talking about the Child Development 1 class. Yay!
So in child development, we study children and how they grow and what their milestones are.
Right now we're learning about like different diseases that children get, and like we took notes on it, so like we're learning about that right now.
We do some projects, and like stuff like how to take care of children.
So we do a lot of hands-on activities where we get to do observations in the daycare and preschool here at West High School. We get to play with the kids, which is awesome. And we do a lot of projects. So child development is a pretty fun class.
Yeah, I would recommend it because not only do you do fun stuff like the projects, but you learn a lot about child development and like how to, you just learn about everything.
So in Early Childhood Education 1 and Early Childhood Education 2, we spend most of our time focusing on how to teach children. So in Early Childhood Education 1, we spend every 2 to 3 weeks teaching in the preschool. And in Early Childhood Education 2, you spend every day in the preschool or daycare. So it's a lot of time with kids. It's a lot of hands-on with them, which is really awesome.
Thank you for watching Electives Elevated West High. Stay tuned next week for I Will Elevate Your Knowledge Again.
This week on our podcast, TV West Saves the World, we sat down with Wyatt, Harper, Carson, and Trayton to talk about some very highly sensitive topics such as Garfield, and we also rated fruit together. To listen to our podcast, TV West Saves the World, you can either click the link in the description or go to SoundCloud and look for TV West Saves the World. And follow us for more episodes to come.
Hey guys, Will here. Today I'm going to teach you how to get food and water. The first thing that you got to do is go down to a body of water like a river, and then check if the water is clean enough. This river water should be clean enough. And then you can drink the water either by scooping it up with your hands or scooping it up with a bottle if you bring one. Now to make the complete meal, we got to go collect some food, in this case berries.
We can't find any berries around here, so you would just eat this kind of berry if you found one.
Early Neanderthals hunted primarily meat, including mammoths, but an ideal thing would be not to kill any animals around here. Now we can enjoy our meal.